In the last class, we were studying about the methods of preparation and properties of haloalkanes. Today, we are going to study about alcohols. So the objectives of today's lesson are, one, to understand the general methods of preparation of alcohols, the general properties of alcohols, and finally, we will make a conversion chart. And with the help of the conversion chart, we will do a few standard conversions. Hi students, today we are going to study about alcohols. So as usual, the objectives of the lesson are methods of preparation of alcohols and properties of alcohols. At the end of the chapter, so we will make a conversion chart of alcohols that will be useful for the revision. So let us see the methods of preparation. So alcohols are prepared from alkenes. It is called hydration in the presence of proton. It will change into alcohol. Method number two, it can be prepared from chloroethane. When chloroethane is treated with the sodium hydroxide, we will get ethanol, which is a typical member of alcohol. Now from aldehydes we can prepare. When an aldehyde is produced in the presence of hydrogen, and which are the hydrogenation catalysts, nickel, platinum, or even palladium, anyone, we will get ethanol. Next one is the reaction with the sodium borohydride. Another one, reducing agent, a common reducing agent is lithium aluminum hydride, but only limitation of lithium aluminum hydride is it is very expensive. Now when from carboxylic acid we can prepare alcohol. When a carboxylic acid is reduced with lithium aluminum hydride, we will get an alcohol. Next one is the industrial method of preparation of alcohol. It is called fermentation. So when sucrose, I mean sugar solution, is subjected to fermentation, so two enzymes are taking part in this reaction. One is invertase, it will convert sucrose into glucose and fructose, that will be converted into ethanol and carbon dioxide by the second enzyme, cyanase. Now we are going to study the properties of alcohols. First is the reaction with the metallic sodium. We will get effervescence. The effervescence is due to the liberation of hydrogen gas. So alcohols will react with the sodium giving alkoxide, sodium alkoxide, along with the hydrogen gas is liberated. It's a test for alcohols. Second is the reaction with the carboxylic acid. With the carboxylic acids, we will be getting ester. The reaction is called esterification. Next one is the reaction with the acetyl chloride. There also we are going to get ester. Now reaction with the hydrogen chloride and acetyl CH2, which is called gross process, we will get monoethylene. When an alcohol is treated with the PCl3, PCl5 or SOCl2, we will get haloalkane. So here the typical alcohol is ethanol. When ethanol is treated with the PCl3, PCl5 or SOCl2, we will get a haloalkane. Next one is the reaction with the concentrated sulfuric acid. Look at the temperature, 443 Kelvin. So we will be getting an alkene and water. It is called a dehydration because sulfuric acid is a dehydrating agent. Now with the CrO3 or even with the pyridinium chlorobromate, they are mild oxidizing agents. So an alcohol will change into aldehyde, which is an intermediate. So normally with the strong oxidizing agents, alcohols will change into carboxylic acid, but with the PCC or even CrO3, we are getting aldehydes, and this is a method for converting alcohols into aldehydes. But with the strong oxidizing agents like potassium dichromate and sulfuric acid or even KNNO4 and OH-, we will be getting the carboxylic acid. So these are the important reactions of alcohols. So we studied the methods of preparation and we studied the important properties of alcohols. Now try to make a conversion chart. Please watch my video, share it, like it, and subscribe. Thank you.